blazes did I put it? Gotta be here somewhere. I know I couldn't have lost it.
Sweetheart, what on earth are you looking for?
The X-ray photo I took of Prince Rex. It's getting late. He'll be here soon.
But David, you know that clock isn't running.
By golly, you're right. I plumb forgot.
Oh. What in the world could this be? Who'd save a piece of plain black paper? This yours, Grandpa?
Huh? You want to know what this thing is?
Mm-hmm.
Huh. This is exactly what I was looking for.
But what is it?
It's the X-ray photograph of Prince Rex.
The picture's completely blank.
Wait. Ah, there they are. Now you should be able to see the X-ray properly, Susan.
Huh? Hmm? Oh, why, it's a picture of a skeleton.
It's an X-ray photo of Prince Rex. With these glasses, we doctors can get a peek at the insides of our patients, see?
Hmm. Oh, I get it now. Hmm.
That's why you can see right through to a skeleton.
So this is the inside of the prince? Is he this ugly on the outside, too?
No, child, he's not ugly at all. When he gets here, you'll see, and you'll soon change your tune.
This X-ray was taken way back when the prince was still just a youngster. Back then, he was almost half an inch shorter than his twin brother.
Hmm. Oh, you can study anatomy with this. You can see all the bones we gnomes have clear as day.
Oh, that's right, Susan. Our heads are larger in proportion to our bodies than human heads are. We've got 8 pairs of ribs, 4 of them solid and 4 floating, while humans have 7 solid and 5 floating.
And the arms?
Compared to humans, our arms are longer and our legs are shorter. Did you know we gnomes look like that inside?
Mm-hmm. Hmm. Do I look like that inside, too?
Of course you do. Our livers are bigger and sturdier than human livers. Maybe that's why we live so much longer than they do. I'll put away my X-rays so I won't lose them again. I keep all my medical case histories in here. I'll bet the prince would like to see his X-ray.
Oh, what's this?
Are you planning to study medicine?
Oh!
My goodness, what's the matter, dear?
Nothing, it's just that I can see a gnome heart here. It's so big.
Our blood whooshes through our veins much faster than in humans. That's the reason why we have to have such big, powerful hearts, even though we're very small.
These glasses give me the willies. Things look better on the outside. Someone's knocking.
That must be the prince now. Hello, dear Rex.
Lisa!
Come in. Oh, welcome, Prince.
Lisa, you're as lovely as the day I first met you.
Oh, you flatterer. How was the trip from Australia? Good weather?
Beautiful, all the way.
Hello there, Rex. It's good to see your beardless face again.
Oh, David.
But really, Rex, you look great. Tell me, how's your father, my old pal, the king?
He's in excellent health, David, and he sends you his fondest regards, eh?
Oh.
Oh, silly me. You two haven't met yet. I better introduce you. This pretty little lady is none other than our granddaughter, Susan. I'd like you to meet a dear friend of mine, the Royal Prince Rex of Australia.
Delighted.
Susan, dear, please come over and say hello to Prince Rex.
It's a pleasure to make your acquaintance, Prince Rex.
Oh, please, Susan, let's not be so formal. Couldn't we get to know each other a little better?
I hope you enjoy your stay in our country.
Thanks.
Okay, enough is enough. Let's skip all this mushy stuff and we'll have a nice, cool drink. I made my very own secret recipe fruit punch just for you.
Thank you, Lisa. You remember how much I like your fruit punch.
Grandpa, can you tell me, why is the prince so tall?
He is a bit taller than most gnomes. I'm surprised that you noticed, Susan.
Hey, you two, will you let us in on your secret?
Please, Grandpa, don't tell. I'll be utterly mortified. Mm-hmm.
Susan and I were just discussing Lisa's secret recipe for fruit punch.
Come on, Susan. What are you waiting for?
Cheers. It's a real treat to see you two again. Your grandfather once saved my life, Susan.
Your father and I have been good friends for years. That's why he called me to Australia to look after you. That's what Susan was just asking me.
Oh, no, Grandpa, please don't say it.
She was wondering why Lisa and I made a journey to a country as far away as Australia.
I'm sure Australia is a very beautiful country.
Your grandparents came to my country to treat a condition I had. I wasn't growing at all.
Grandpa told me you were almost half an inch shorter than your brother.
Yes, his twin brother Tom was taller, and nobody could figure out why Rex wasn't growing. It was a real mystery. That's when I received an urgent call from the King of Australia. Naturally, your grandmother and I set sail for the land down under immediately. On a previous trip to Holland, we brought back a wooden shoe as a souvenir, and it came in very handy for that long sea voyage.
Look, David, I can see land up ahead.
Yes, we finally reached our destination, Lisa. It's Australia. It'll be so nice to have the pleasure of seeing good King Christopher and his family again.
The landscape is fantastic. Just look at those mountains over there.
Yeah. Looks like the water's too shallow. I'll hop out and carry you in my arms so you won't get wet. Jump, Lisa. Don't be afraid. Come on. What are you waiting for? This rock is slippery. I think we landed right on top of a turtle. Would you mind taking us ashore, please? You've been most helpful, Brother Turtle. Could you keep an eye on our ship?
Do you think we'll be here for a long time, dear?
Just as long as it takes to fix up the prince. Huh? What's that noise? Well, what do you know? It's a kangaroo. You scared us silly. Lisa, Australia is the land of the kangaroos. They're friendly with the gnomes who live here and give them lots of help.
I'm glad to hear it. I was frightened.
Good morning down there.
Why, it's a gnome.
Yes. I'm David, and this is my wife, Lisa.
Hello. Do you live in there?
I'm the royal courier to take you to the king, the Earl of Sandwich, you know. Do climb aboard my kangaroo. She'll take us to the king in a hop.
Hush, dear.
Riding in a kangaroo's pouch is an elegant way to travel over here.
You mean we have to ride inside an animal? How awful.
Down we go. Come along. Here we are. Tally-ho, Rook-a-roo, let's go hopping. All right, now's your chance to give our guests a ride they'll long remember. Slip into high gear and throw caution to the winds. It's good fun. What'd I tell you? Ripping, eh? Hope it isn't too breezy for you.
It's memorable, all right. Reminds me of the time I fell downstairs.
Oh. What is it with them?
They're betting who can jump across that big hole there.
Better not waste any more time, Earl. The king is waiting.
We've got time, old boy. Let's see who wins the game. Right. Show us what you can do. You can beat those young whippersnappers. Onward, give it the works.
Oh, David, we're gonna crash.
Hang on, honey. We'll make it.
A good try.
Yeah, she missed it by that much.
David, what was that?
A boomerang. It's the hunting weapon of the Australian natives.
That's what it used to be, David, but I suspect that that one belongs to young Prince Rex.
What are you doing down in that hole? Greetings! Dear friends, are you all right?
Your Majesty, hello!
This is embarrassing. David! Lisa!
Hello. Prince Rex and Prince Tom. Well, Prince Rex, I understand you have a problem.
Yeah, you see, I've stopped growing. I want to be as tall as my brother Tom.
Don't you worry, Rex. We're going to find out what's the matter.
It's the strangest thing, David. All of a sudden, you stop growing.
There's bound to be a reason for that. Just sit tight and we'll find it.
Good show. That was a corking shot you did there, Tom.
Please, Rex, will you let me throw your boomerang?
No.
Oh, Rex, you never let me throw it.
Now, don't start that again. Rex is very proud of his boomerang, and he just won't part with it.
It's quite unique. We made it specially for Rex from an old monkey pod tree that was in the garden.
Come on, Rex, show David how beautifully it flies through the air.
That's wonderful, Rex, but I think it's time we checked you over to see what's gone wrong with your growing mechanism.
That's fine, David, but let's all go to the palace first. That'll be a much better place to carry out your medical examination. Friends, let's go.
All right, Rex, let's start your examination. The first thing I want to do is to check your height. Sure enough. Why, there's almost half an inch difference. Now I want to take a look at your insides. Would you step a little closer, Rex?
Sure thing, Dr. David.
There. Let's see what's wrong in there. Open your mouth, please. Okay, you can close it now. Let's see if there's anything the matter with your ears. Fine. Everything's okay. And now, Rex, look me straight in the eye. Very well, young man. All finished, Your Majesty.
Did you find out what's wrong, David?
Will he ever start to grow again so he can be as tall as his brother?
Oh, Rex will start growing again, all right, as soon as we get rid of his allergy. You see, your son is allergic to one particular kind of wood. Are there any monkey pod trees around here?
Not now, but there used to be one in the garden. Rex was always climbing it.
And I'll bet you used that wood to make his boomerang.
Yes. When the tree was chopped down, his father made it for him.
Well, I think we have our answer. Let me see that boomerang, Rex. I think it may be our culprit. Possibly just the natural oils of the wood. It has a very distinctive smell. In fact, it's very pleasant. There's no doubt about it. We're dealing here with a very unusual allergy.
So if I get rid of my allergy, I'll start to grow again.
Don't worry, Rex, my boy. Your worries are over. Here, you just take some of this medicine every day with a tall glass of fruit punch and you'll be fine. It'll counteract the allergy and stimulate your growth. What do you say?
That's great! Thanks a lot.
And just to play it safe, I think we better get rid of this boomerang right away.
Yes, of course.
I don't want it.
Too bad, huh, Lisa?
A splendid catch, David.
You're a natural, Dr. David.
You know, it'd be fun to take it with me and practice at home.
Go ahead and take it. You don't have to grow anymore.
Well, did you enjoy that story, Susan?
Yes, wonderful. I'd like to go to Australia myself sometime.
It's such a beautiful country. I loved it.
The fantastic thing is that part of his cure was just plain fruit punch.
Yes, with his allergy cured, the fruit punch helped him grow.
Susan, would you like some more fruit punch?
Oh. Oh, thank you.
Well, now you know how Prince Rex got to be as tall as his brother Tom, huh, Susan?
Yes, Grandpa, but Prince Rex is taller than other gnomes.
That's right, Susan. And do you want to know why? I'll tell you exactly what happened. Rex got so fond of fruit punch that he kept drinking it. He drank so much with his medicine, he had a super overdose.
Gonna drive by and drink your fruit punch. Let's ride.
Next time, David helps some frightened wolf cubs find their mother during an electrical storm. This reminds David of days gone by when his own children were growing up. But David's awakened from his happy dream of yesterday with a real nightmare. Lisa's been kidnapped by the trolls. What will David do to save her from his arch enemies? Find out right here, next time.